We've got them.
Why don't you ring a bell and tell everybody?
Oh, sorry. When are you going to use them?
Oh, I reckon tonight's as good a time as any. But the keys aren't much good on their own. This is where being a girl guide comes in handy. Okay. Get us some matches and some scissors, all right?
Okay. Hey, Beth, toss us your matches. Come on.
Go. Now, you get the tobacco out of this like that, okay?
What for?
Don't ask questions.
Well, what the hell are we doing anyway?
If you shut up a minute, you might learn something.
I've heard of funny cigarettes, but this is ridiculous.
This is a funny cigarette, all right, but it's not for human consumption. This one's for the screws.
What are you going to do, ask them to have a cigarette with you?
Well, they reckon smoking's a health hazard. I might just prove it to them.
To slow down. Wendy left me a ton of work from yesterday.
Oh, yeah, well, she was a bit snowed under. Look, is there anything else I can do to help you? I finished the filing. What about the visitor's book?
Thanks. You know what to do? Just day and date the top of the page.
Yeah.
What do you think you're doing? That's the visitor's book. You're not supposed to be looking at that.
Well, I'm just...
And where's the supervising officer?
Well, there isn't one. We're a bit understaffed.
Judy isn't supervising here, Mr. Douglas.
Is that a fact? Would you tell the governor I'm here, please? You wait over there.
But I was...
Over there. Oh, at last. I was beginning to think this place is run by the ladies' auxiliary.
Well, there is an explanation, Mr. Douglas.
Yes, there always is. Now, I'd like to see Mrs. Davidson, if that wouldn't be too much trouble.
I'll just check the duty roster.
No, Mrs. Morris, now, if you don't mind.
As you wish.
Should I sign the book first, or have we done away with that as well? Would you see that this book is headed correctly? There's no date.
Oh, brother. You better get your work finished before he gets back. I'll work on the book, huh?
Right, thanks.
Directives have been given and the department expects them to be carried through. Unless your staff have to be spoon-fed, if they're ever here, that is.
That is hardly fair, Mr. Douglas. Until I have checked the rosters thoroughly, I cannot give you a reasonable explanation.
Well, you've got them in front of you. Have a look. It's my guess they've decided to sleep in.
As I said, until I have investigated...
Look, I am not going to argue. This place is a shambles. I never know what's going to happen next. Now what?
That is the fire alarm, Mr. Douglas. Now, if you will excuse me... Yes, emergency. Could you give me the fire brigade, please?
Here, hold it.
What's that? How on earth could a fire start in
there? Nothing had surprised me in this place. Get this mess cleaned up, and then I want a meeting of all senior staff in your office. Immediately.
Very well.
That fire was in the staff room. Now tell me, could a prisoner get in there?
It's impossible unless they walk through one of the security gates.
Well, from what I've seen this morning, it wouldn't surprise me if it was left wide open.
Mr. Douglas, I resent you taking one isolated incident and applying it to the prison in general.
Isolated? Ah, Mr. Fletcher, you shouldn't have hurried in. It's only 10:45. Pity you weren't here earlier. You missed all the firework display.
With all due respects, Mr. Douglas, I wasn't rostered on until mid-afternoon.
All right, you made up those rosters, you tell me. Who do you think's responsible for this fiasco?
I'm afraid we have another problem. That was the gatehouse. Apparently there are 3 fire trucks outside.
Fire trucks?
Oh, of course you wouldn't know. We've had a very busy morning. The staff room caught fire. Pity he wasn't left a little longer, really. The whole prison might have burned to the ground.
Mr. Douglas!
Would somebody please explain?
One of the lockers caught fire in the staff room.
How could a locker catch fire? Yes, how indeed? Especially when all the security gates are supposed to be locked at all times.
What are you implying?
From what I've seen today, who's to say it wasn't staff negligence?
Mr. Douglas, it could have been an accident. Accidents do happen in prison.
Only because prisoners are left unsupervised and make them happen. All right, well, the picnic's over. This place is going to be tightened up.
We are listening, Mr. Douglas.
My plan is to control the women from within their own ranks. Internal harmony. In order to do that, I've arranged the transfer of one of the women from Barnhurst.
Don't you think that'll be adding to our problems?
Not the way I see it. I'm sure it's the only answer.
And who is this miracle worker going to be?
Now, she's no stranger to Wentworth. I think you know her. Mari Winter.
Mari Winter? Well, I hardly...
The matter is closed. She arrives this morning. It's obvious your staff can't control the women. Let's see if she can.
Well, I've seen happier faces than that.
Not here, you haven't. Not unless they were getting out.
Well, what are you staring at?
Nothing. Big, fat nothing. I just want to go to this bed, this room, this whole crummy prison.
Look, if you want to feel sorry for yourself, that's fine by me. But personally, I think you're being a little bit ungrateful. There are a lot of people in here working very hard for you, B. I
didn't ask for a lecture.
I'm not giving one. There are other people with problems too, you know.
Yeah. And I'm the only one who's dying.
Miss Conway, the governor would like to see you. Straight away, if you can.
Well, here's a pretty boy, then.
None of your business.
Conway, you were rostered on duty this morning, and yet you have only just recently arrived. Do you have a reason?
Well, yes, as I explained to you on the phone this morning, I didn't think I was expected until this afternoon. Now, I checked the rosters last night on the way home.
I asked Mrs. Morris to collect the rosters from the staff room, reception, and this is my own copy.
Well, I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson. These aren't the rosters I saw last night.
Anyone can make a mistake, but I do not have the time nor the energy for people who persist in covering up. I expect a vast improvement in your performance in general, especially at a time when we are tightening up security. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, but I wasn't making excuses. Now, how do you explain the other officers who didn't arrive this morning?
I do not have to explain it. Admittedly, you were not the only one, but there is the proof on the desk.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
We will continue this conversation later when I have interviewed the rest of the staff. In the meantime, report to reception and induct the new prisoner. I hope this is something you can get right.
I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but your conduct as a parole officer has been brought into question.
My conduct?
That's right.
I wasn't aware that my work in that area was under investigation.
I'm afraid so. And now I have to draw your attention to some rather startling allegations.
Such as?
A mishandling of a case involving a Wentworth escapee.
That matter is fully documented in my reports.
I've read those reports. They're grossly inadequate.
The reports contained everything I thought relevant to the department.
Everything is relevant, Mrs. Morris. Every little detail must be included, and you know it.
Parolees and prisoners are entitled to my discretion.
Oh, you're sailing very close to the wind. You keep on with this attitude, you'll regret it.
Look, I'm very busy. If you've got nothing more to say...
Only that I regard it a very great pity that you have such little regard for your career, which up till now has held great promise.